morning, crew. Good morning, Dennis.
Good morning.
How are you?
Fine, thank you.
We were just having a bit of a natter about your kind of musical tastes and stuff, and you're a big Ted Nugent fan.
Yes, unfortunately for my girlfriend, yes, who can't stand him.
Does she get dragged to the gigs as well?
She doesn't know. She's not seen him before, no, but she tends to think that they all sound the same, but there you go.
what a critic.
Something like that, yeah.
So you've obviously seen him a fair few times. Did you see him at the... I saw him a couple of months back at the Indigo 2 in London. Were you at that gig?
I couldn't. I was working that night. I've been down to see him before, you know, down to London about 6-7 years ago in the Astoria. Brilliant show.
Well, I'm not quite sure who the two guys he's playing with are at the minute, but they were a hell of a band. Great sort of three-piece.
Yeah, he seems to, you know, change his band every tour.
Yeah.
You know, he's very fussy about who he plays with.
And that's...
He's never had, you know, a stable lineup from anything more than sort of 2 years.
Yeah, no, it was a cracking gig, though. What about politically? Because he's quite outspoken, isn't he?
No, I sort of try and avoid that sort of, you know, thing. He's got a, you know, as any sort of a, you know, sort of talented guitarist, have a bit of an ego. But, I mean, his politics I try and ignore and just try and concentrate on the music, really.
Do you know, I've always thought that if Alice Cooper ever needs any time off the breakfast show, Ted Nugent as a stand-in, I think, would be brilliant.
You'd get no music played, does he? He'd just be talking.
I know. And we'd probably get halfway through his views on foreign policy and we'd get taken off the air, but my God, it'd be a funny morning.
I know, he does a lot of interviews on American radio, you can watch on YouTube, and you can see the interviewers of a... gnashing the teeth because I can't get words in edgeways. You'll ask him a question and he'll go off on a completely different tangent.
Yeah, no, amazing character. Well, listen, hopefully next time you go and see Ted, you'll be wearing your Planet Rock anorak, Dennis.
Hopefully, it was a bit cold at work last night, so I could have done it. It was -2 in the factory last night, so I could have done with it last night.
You're joking?
Yeah, no.
Well, the beautiful quality of the Planet Rock anorak will maybe keep you warm.
Very good, yeah, I'll do my best.
Good, man. Well, the target set yesterday was 7 correct answers, so that's what we're going to try and beat.
I got about 9 yesterday, actually.
No, that's the kiss of death. You see that schoolboy error there.
Yeah.
But we'll see how you've done. You scored 9 yesterday, Dennis. Let's see how you do. Best of luck.
Fine, thank you.
60 seconds starts now. In which year did Van Halen release their first album?
1977.
John Entwistle, best known for playing bass in which band? Technical Ecstasy and Master of Reality. Name Thunder's lead singer.
Danny Bowe.
In which year did Guns N' Roses release their Use Your Illusion albums?
1991.
Oh, pilot of the storm that leaves no trace, like thoughts inside a dream. Lines from which Led Zeppelin song?
Pass.
Complete the title of the 1976 Genesis album, A Trick of...
The Tail.
2007's The Inner Sanctum is an album from which British band?
Pass.
Flight of the Rat and Hard Loving Man first appeared on which Deep Purple album?
Machine Head.
Singer and Planet Rock presenter Vincent Damon Furnier is better known as who? Which guitarist was sometimes backed by the band Double Trouble? In the late 60s, Martin and Ted Turner became founder members of which band? Just got in there. In the nick of time. You get a couple of minutes breather now. We'll find out how you've done after Gary Moore.
If you're wrong or if you're
find out how our contestant Dennis has done on the Anorak quiz. I tell you what, Dennis, you know when I said how did you do yesterday and you said 9?
Yeah.
Normally when people say that they crash and burn.
Right, yeah.
When they come to do it. But I think confidence may have paid off. You're rattling through it. Let's find out exactly what you got. Van Halen, I'm afraid one of the few you didn't get. Van Halen, first album from 78, just the 1 year out on that. John Entwistle, of course, best known for playing bass in The Who. Technical Ecstasy and Master of Reality, both from Black Sabbath. Thunders, lead singer, as you said, Danny Bose. The User Illusion albums came in 1991 from Guns N' Roses. Oh, Pilot of the Storm that Leaves No Trace, like Thoughts Inside a Dream from Zeppelin's Kashmir. You got Genesis, Trick of the Tail from 76. The Inner Sanctum album from Saxon from not so long back. We had the tracks from Deep Purple in Rock. We had Alice Cooper, of course, born Vincent Damon Furnier. The guitarist that's backed by Double Trouble, as you said, Stevie Ray Vaughan. And you just got in there. Well done, Nick of Time. Martin and Ted Turner, founder members of Wishbone Ash, which I think gives you a big, fat, juicy 8.
Blimey.
Congratulations.
Right.
Very good score. I thought Martin, who phoned up yesterday and got 7, I thought he could have been top of the pile all week.
I'm not sure where the Wishbone Ash won't come from, but...
Did it just appear from nowhere?
Yeah, with the Van Halen, I used to have like a lot of live tapes from 1977, and that's what sort of threw me rather than the 78.
Well, this is all semantics. It's a cracking score. You have done very well. Obviously, everyone's going to try and beat you now, Dennis.
Yeah, well, bring it on.
A confident man. A man quite possibly worthy of the Planet Rock Anorak. Can you beat 8? Give us a ring tomorrow.